Hi, everyone. My name is Keith Mercier, and I'm the Vice President in the Worldwide Retail and Consumer Goods Industry team at Microsoft. And I could not be more delighted to welcome with me today Aude Gandon, the Global Chief Marketing Officer at Nestle. Aude, thank you so much for joining us today. I'm so excited.
Thank you, Keith. Delighted to see you, and thank you for having me.
You know, from your vantage point, how is AI currently being used in Nestle in the different lines of business?
Wow, yes, this is definitely the topic of the year, and I'm sure of the decade. So AI, of course, is not new at Nestle and has been used pretty broadly for the past kind of few years across all functions. Gen AI is, of course, the latest kind of news. And we are already leveraging the power of AI everywhere, from R&D, really using AI to get faster concepting, faster testing, and also, you know, faster feedback on some of the innovation or some of the new kind of product concept we have, to supply chain, to finance, and then of course to marketing. Our whole generating demand organization is now leveraging a lot of new AI tools, from content creation to analytics, and of course media.
Yeah, there's been so much talk about the excitement of adopting AI inside of different enterprises, and one of the biggest questions, of course, is about the benefits. So maybe you could share a little bit about some of the main benefits that you're seeing and the impact you're seeing for using AI across your business.
Yes, it's definitely creating a whole new world of opportunities across the whole marketing value chain. We've been waiting and promising for a very long time to have personalization at scale. And thanks to Gen AI, it is becoming a reality. From personalized conversations to personalized media, for example. On the personalized conversations, in our latest Good For You chatbot, we have been leveraging the Azure AI services, for example, and suddenly it is completely transforming the way we actually exchange with our consumers and the way we can actually provide them really personalized recipes, but also ideas on how to achieve a tasty and balanced diet.
I love that use case, especially with that interaction you're creating with your consumers and all of the new data you're collecting as they engage with the Good For You chatbot. A lot of our customers ask, help us avoid making mistakes when we're adopting Gen AI. Are there any learnings that you can share about the implementation process at Nestle?
Yes, first, do not believe that suddenly magic happens and you will get the value at the touch of a button. You need to make sure that you have the right tech infrastructure, you have the right data infrastructure, you know, revisit your taxonomy, because if you don't have, you know, this really kind of transformed and really kind of pinned down, you will never completely leverage the power of Gen AI. And then you can really start implementing and really start kind of learning and start to understand what is going to be the transformation power of such a technology. But I really believe that we need to be very careful in what are the KPIs and what are the expectations. There was a bit of a high level of expectation in the beginning, and what we've learned is it is delivering and we're only scratching the surface. It is definitely going to be transformational. But if we don't have the due diligence of the right structure, but also really understanding what to expect and also how to help all our employees to really embrace it, but also learn how to use it, I don't think you get the value.
Yeah, I love that. I'll summarize it. The right technology stack, the right data process, and most importantly, setting the right expectations with the right KPIs. Thank you for sharing that. Okay, maybe we'll shift a little bit to the future.
Yep.
And it's hard to talk about the future in AI because the future is really in the next 3 months because it changes so fast. But what are your future plans as you think about AI in Nestle's marketing business?
How we can get even more kind of automated content, part of the transformation of marketing today is what we call the multiplicity factor, or the power of multiplicity. Sometimes, you know, we forget that it's not just the multiplication of the different kind of digital platforms, but it's also the multiplication of the different formats. Instagram has 6 formats within the platform, which means that for us as advertisers, it's not just one campaign, it's one campaign which needs to kind of then be translated into the 6 different formats. And we need to do the same with YouTube and TikTok and so on and so forth. And so that's where GenAI is absolutely incredible, because we can really start to do a lot more of development of content for all the creative platforms. We are also, of course, doing a lot of digital twins for our packaging, which means that we can really create new content, you know, within a few minutes. And that is something which is key for us, when you see our size, but also our global footprint and the number of brands we have. What we've been doing together, you know, we talked about the chatbot, but it's actually, you know, we really want to scale this across a lot of businesses. And that we need, because that's also what consumers are expecting. They're expecting us to provide more services, to provide more answers. It needs to be done in a way which is obviously very private, but also which kind of give us the right analytics and anonymized analytics. And this is why, you know, for us, again, you know, the Asia suite is incredible for us. And then we have everything through media, as I mentioned earlier. In a world where we can get more and more automation, but also more and more intelligence, and we can really serve really the personalized message to each and different consumer, GenAI is definitely going to be extremely powerful for us.
As you think about AI evolving at Nestle, and even kind of zooming out around the consumer goods industry, you know, how do you see the use of AI kind of evolving over the years?
Well, when you see the speed of adoption just over the past kind of 18 months, it is pretty crazy. But also we need to remember that all these technologies are really becoming available to everybody. And so we need to embrace them. We need to understand what is the best use of them. But as a consumer goods company and being a marketer, I think what we need to make sure is that we don't do it at the expense of all the fundamentals of marketing. And GenAI is definitely going also potentially to take us there. So the power of GenAI linked to all the marketing fundamentals of what make a brand, how a brand can resonate and be relevant to a consumer, the balance of the two, I think, is going to create magic.
So, you know, what advice could you share for other consumer goods companies that are looking to start to implement AI and go on the same journey that Nestle has been on for the last year?
Be focused and also kind of make some priorities. So the way when we're starting on our road to the development of GenAI, at least in the marketing organization, we've been very clear on where do we want first to implement GenAI and where we believe that we're going to get the best value straight away as the technology was developing, but also as our teams were starting to get accustomed to it. So we really went into insight to innovation, direct access to consumer and consumer experiences, next level content and design, and then the always on analytics. And we decided these 5 areas is where we're going to focus first.
Ode, thank you again for doing this. So great to have you with us today. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Keith. Delighted to be with you today.